Word in 5.
In the 6th chapter of Exodus, something new was introduced into the life of the Israelites. God fed them with manna. When they got into the wilderness, they started troubling Moses, asking for food. Some of them said, "Have you brought us into this wilderness to kill us?" And so Moses reported the incident to the Lord, and the Lord said he was going to give them food the next day. Early the next morning, they saw something strange on the floor. Looks like wafer, tastes like wafer dipped in honey. I really want to taste manna someday, because the description of it makes it something good. The children of Israel tasted it and they loved it. And this is the food God fed them with all through their sojourn in the wilderness. I remember one of the promises God made unto Israel is that he was going to heal them of all diseases. He actually said no disease of Egypt will come upon them. And as I start to study the scriptures, I think the reason they were going to have divine health is because they were having divine diet. Being used to Egypt, they coveted the onions of Egypt and the meat of Egypt and the cucumbers and all of the things they were used to, all of the delicacies of Egypt. If they ate that, then they would not be too far away from the diseases of Egypt, because I believed the diet and the earth are very, very related. God wanted them to eat heavenly food so that they would have heavenly health. God wants you to eat heavenly food so that you will have heavenly lifestyle. I believe that manna is representative of the word of God. Any man who feed himself with the word of God, who live by the word of God and the instructions of the heavens, will have an heavenly lifestyle. Anybody who feed on the works of Egypt and the principles of men can only have a carnal lifestyle. Friends, I think it is time we begin to take the word of God seriously. We begin to eat manna as if our life depends on it. And that is reading the word of God, memorizing the word of God, meditating on it and acting by it. These are the instructions of the heaven. The word of God is how God sees man living on his earth. They describe to us the way man can live on the earth of God and fulfill the mandate of the Father. So we can't do without the manna. We cannot do without eating this heavenly diet. I am rejoicing daily as I go to the Lord and he feed me with manna. I think everything in the world has answers, but only the answer of God works. And I challenge you, try to apply manna to your situation. You will agree with me as you practice it that heavenly diet will lead to heavenly lifestyle. God bless you.
All right, Hodge, you take it. First, you gotta sing the word to speak the word to life. It's in the book. Look, read the verses twice. You can possess the best of the best, and yes, if you confess it, it could be yours unless you don't believe. But we got faith and we speak life. I wish that y'all could see your face, cause I see prosperity, greatness all over you. Just speak it and God will start showing you. Your ministry is built on faith. Your calendar about to be booked for 12 months straight. See, certain levels was unreachable, but if you just speak it, who am I preaching to? I'm not here to rap, I'm just teaching you. The word works, but first you gotta speak it to your life. Every goal is still achievable, so believe it, receive it, release it right now.
One word away,
cause it's only
one word away.
One word away,
power of life.
working.